Hey, Mr. McLaren here. So I want to go over this assignment around virtual inquiry cubes. Essentially, what you're going to be doing is looking at these 3D model cubes and trying to figure out what goes on the blank side here. And this is really just like a practice where you're trying to problem solve. So you're looking at this cube and you've got some familiarity with a dice. So you may have some idea as to what goes on this blank side. So you may have a couple strategies to try and look for patterns to try and figure out what that number is. A lot of people will just count all the way around and like just look at them and like keep track of it. There's a ton of different strategies you can do, but one that I actually just learned this yesterday was if you look at the opposite sides, they always add up to 7. So I've got 2 and 5. So that adds up to 7, right? About 6, which means what should be on the opposite side. If you said 1, you're correct. So 1 across from 6, 2 across from 5. So you ask yourself, what's across from 3? What should be 4, right? So that's your process for trying to solve these things, where you're trying to figure out what the number is on the other on this blank side. So then it jumps up to some much, much, much more difficult things that you're doing here for these higher ones, like level 1. It's got a couple different things, but it's got the same sort of idea where you're looking between the sides and trying to find like a pattern. So you might like focus in on the center here and just be like, what's going on in the center there? Okay. And so you've got like 1, 3, 5, 4, 2. So you might be like, I don't know. I think this other number is going to go in the center here. So you're trying to just kind of fill in the blank, essentially, like trying to figure out what would go in this blank side following the pattern that you're seeing. Or like here, it looks like I'm seeing like 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. That seems to be following a pattern to me where it's like doubling up in some way. So I think that there's something going on with doubling there. So you're looking for these patterns and trying to, from those patterns, figure out what would be on the blank side. Now I've made this little quiz that should let you self-check that. So if you were to go onto the link for that virtual inquiry cubes, which I believe I'm going to have a link in the quiz, it should also be linked in the modules. I haven't got it right now, but it should be like right here. And I'll also have it linked in the discussion to get to this website. So if you look at these questions here, you could type in something. So I'm just going to type in 1 for a couple of these just to see if that's the answer. And then you can submit that quiz. It should tell you if you got it correct or not. It won't tell you what the correct answer is. It'll just tell you if you are correct. Remember, it should have been 4 here, so it should say correct if I'd gotten that right. So this is just a little tool. There's no points assigned to any of these questions. It's just to help you kind of play around with this and see if you can get it. I think I only did this for up to level 2. I don't think I did level 3 and 4. So you'll have to get those answers from each other, which actually transitioned us perfectly to the discussion. So the discussion, basically, you're going to be typing out what patterns you're noticing between the sides on these cubes. And what methods you're trying to use to solve them. One method would be looking across like at the opposite side, and one would be looking for like things being added or multiplied in a certain pattern or something like that. And then so you're gonna type out your method in this discussion. When you submit that, I believe you'll be able to see other people's submissions, so you'll see their methods, and then you guys will also be able to comment on each other's to be able to ask questions and share answers. So if you're like, I got really stuck here, I think it was this, but I'm not sure, you could write that in your discussion. And then someone could come in and put a comment and be like, I saw the same thing. I agree with you. I think that's the pattern. Or someone might say, yeah, I think it's actually this is the pattern. So there's a number of ways that you can contribute to the conversation. You're just kind of looking at what someone was saying and adding to it. And I would like you to try and do that for one other person, but I know that some people are going to look at this and be like, I don't even know how to get started. So what I would do if I were you is I would look at other people's responses, try and go back and see if you can do it, and then you can ask other questions further, to further clarify things. But remember, those responses are optional. You just need to kind of type out some method that you've got for looking at it. It could be looking for multiplying or looking for addition patterns between the sides, something like that. Yeah, cool. I'll see you in class.